Glyn Blackwell is always the television match official. And here comes Solomon Dykes. Year 7 at St. Joseph's and Pukekohe. Big moment for him. Striding out nicely. Favourite County's Manukau player, Augustine Pulu. Yeah, give it a thumbs up. Good on you, Solomon. Loving it and laughing it up. Look at that smile.
Sorry, am I right to go?
That's what it's all about. Well, as we get set, Holland's head to get us underway. And the final game of week 4 is underway. It's an awkward bounce for Kane Hansey. Takes it eventually, but then he gets swamped and ducks under Elijah Nicholas, and he gets ridden to the ground. Tufo's going to go in and play halfback. Puts the ball back onto the right foot. Sitting back and waiting is Tia Tia with room. Wide it goes. Holland's head to try and work this out wide. Little cutback ball there for Kraft Chemis, and then it's Nemani moved into centre for this game. Out it comes Holland's head. There's Bardor with the first of many carries. Nice offloads as well. Pitanga with a nice carry. Toma. Holland's head. Nemani to the line. Oh, get through Hansey before he's ridden to the ground nicely by Vaka. This is a good start by the Steamers. Why'd they come again? Ritalik, Bardul. Sweeping on it. Counties have got the opportunity to counter-attack. Tupor. Tupor gets it away. Ralasia, I should say. Excuse me. Vaka just outside the 22. Hansey in. Firth. Head down and driving the tight head. Good defence though by Bay of Plenty. And they've turned it over. Toma. Trying to dance his way through. It's nice work from Eru. Still going Shan. They've managed to get him down. Toma. Away it comes Ritalik. He takes the contact and looks to present and does so well. Toma. Lost the footing. Penalty.
Clean out past the ball.
There against Nathan Harris, that went scudding his way through there. Oh, Ben Castle, good start by your former province to this game.
Oh, very good start, and thanks, Nigel. Good afternoon to everyone tuning in. Big game for Bay of Plenty, and a good start for Bay of Plenty, as you mentioned, but equally good defence from counties. See, they're throwing the ball around, a little bit of enterprise early on, and the selection of Bardor in the number 4 jersey shows they use the ball and
good gap here, please, make sure they
be fairly abrasive
here
at the breakdown. It's good to see.
So that's a line-out throw for Afatasi Sua. Over the top. And there's an opportunity for Toma trying to bounce his way through. Drop the hip. Nice tackle by Deteri. More ball for Bay of Plenty. Wide it comes. It sits up. Nemani. Can he get it away to Tia Tia? Yes, he can. Chase to the line. They won't get him. Chase Tia Tia. Completes a great opening 2.5 minutes for Bay of Plenty. And they hit the front by 5 points to 0.
Oh, well, Matthew Cooper on the sideline. He's done a bit of time out in the back line. That was a lovely bit of work there, wasn't it, Coops?
Oh, thanks, Ben. It was. It was a lovely play. Tino Nemani has been excellent to start this game off. The forwards, Bardul, Nigel's already called him. But look at Nemani here. Just lovely little play there. He held the ball up nicely. The defence is far too wide. Fullback too far up there in terms of the Jared Page, and just a lovely finish there. This is a very good start to a team that's had a long week after that big loss, that heavy loss to Waikato last Sunday in Tauranga.
Fourth try of the year for Chase Tia Tia, 19 years of age. You can see why Clayton McMillan was so keen to get a hold on him, and also why Clayton McMillan was a little bit surprised that Wellington didn't want him in the first place. Here's Holland's head to convert. Extras added. Full allotment for Bay of Plenty have made a great start here at Ecolite Stadium in Pukekohe.
It was a lovely interplay, wasn't it, between the backs and forwards possession. You've got to start the game well. They're going into a breeze, just a quick update. They're going into the breeze. County's elected to receive. And so Bay of Plenty got a bit of work to do, but I tell you what, 7-0 start after 4 minutes. Excellent start.
Well, that's not going to help either, as the Teddy with a poor restart, and they're going to come back to halfway for a scrum. Well, so there is the option as well to take the line out, but they're going to come back and set a scrum, and shaking the head there. And Nathan Deteri is getting the start with no Piers Francis available for this game. Well, there you go. You can see Bayer Plenty setting up.
Stop pre-engage.
Tia Tia in behind Holland's head. There they are. The I formation for those who like a bit of NFL parlance. There's a fair few of them around at the moment.
Crouch. Long fine, Mona. Fine.
Slight pack weight advantage to the boys in blue and gold. Feed. Down it goes. Penalty.
Collapsing.
Well, good start, Counties. That scrum, Jared Firth. That time, the Counties tight head. Just really applying the pressure there on Sakalea Solomona. Couldn't handle that pressure. They are a very good scrummaging team, Counties. Puliasi Manu and the loose head jumper. And Jared Firth with some experience. There he is there. You can see that the weight comes on. Jordan Tafua doing a lot of work. Solomona right in front of Richard Kelly.
Good attacking chance here for Counties. Trailing by 7-0. Going, it's taken down. Nice stuff by Dubois. Away comes Tafua. Hansi, short ball. Crash ball by Paulu. Always gets over the gain line, it seems. It's a nice carry by Sua. Flung to the ground. But messy for Hansi. Looks to go that blind side. Teteri spins his way through. This will be...
easy five.
It's Callum Ritalik.
I've got it.
Two boys. Captain and co-captain have a discussion.
Yep.
And it's going to be Jared Page to take a shot for goal.
Well, big Callum Ritalik, co-captain. Penalised there for a high shot. Big man. In his 87th match for Bay of Plenty. We'll get a shot of it here. He's off the line well. Oh, wow. When you're that big, it's hard to step. Sometimes the arm comes out. A fair call.
So here is Jared Page, who you may remember played in those pre-season Shield games. About 33 points, I think it was Paul Mazer telling me prior to the start of this game. He got one of those Shield challenges. Well, that just shows you the strength of that breeze. He did pull it, but the breeze really got underneath that one. That looks like, Matthew Cooper, it's going to be a very challenging end for goal kickers.
Well, it is. I mean, that's a swirler. My climatic or weather conditions, in terms of my word, was said it was going the other way. So that just proves you how swirling it is, Nigel. Long, deep kick out from Bay.
That gives his mama Vitola room to rumble forward. Big, strong carry. Hansi. Well, poor pass going back. It's going to be Vainga. They look to get this ball out wide. Here comes Vaka. Quickly on him. And have they turned that one over, Bay of Plenty? I think they think they've got it. Hansi barking instructions as well. No, it comes back on the steamer's side. Ritalik. Holland's here. Coming on the cutters. Tia Tia showing, going. Gets that ball free again. Tahi Toma trying to break free. And he does break free. Needs the support, gets it. Well, there was Solomona, Sakalia, Ritalik, Holland's head, juggled by Axton's. Still a little bit fractured at the moment, County's Manukau, but they've done enough to disrupt and turn over. Vaipolu, Teteri looking. Good strong carry once again. There was Hukutai coming in off that right wing. Hansi, Teteri in the pocket, clearing for touch. Finds it. Nice take by Matthew Cooper. Sideline, one-handed, holding the microphone. He's still got it, the former All Black and Croatian rugby international.
Slight juggle.
Well, we get the break from Toma. This is off Chase Tete as well, taking it to the line. Still presence of mind to keep the ball up. The support rolling through Counties. Will we have to shore up their defence around those areas?
The turnover too from Tino Namani over the other side of the field. Excellent start from the centre.
No, I'll stop. Both
Richard
sides,
Kelly here.
Lifting early. I need you to wait for the ball. Let's have it again.
Harris will reset. Call comes back in again from Retallick. Calls his own number. Thorman gets it out. They look to try and work their way through. That ball has been lost forward. Diving on it is Vaitolu. Gets up and gains a few metres. Hanson. Get this away. Lawrenson. Take him down. It's Sean Edu with the tackle. Hansi. Poliasi Manu. Strong run again. Hansi. Radasea. Tries to get the ball free. Does so. Lord knows how, but they've knocked it on. Counter-attack opportunity. Here's Nemani. Still getting rid of them, Big Tino. Flicks the ball out. Picked up nicely. The Laiapatanga, I think it might have been. Tome. Tia Tia. Harris. Pop the ball up. Jared Firth reaches down. Ball. Foot goes into touch. I'm going to play the advantage.
Who's ball?
Well, it's good to see both sides, when they are turning the ball over, they're willing to play.
Let's have a better gap at the front, please.
And here's Tino Nemani. Off he goes on the right foot, and here's the power. Look at this collision here. Bang. Still going. Very impressive in the midfield.
Just a little bit more structure from Bay of Plenty. Two individual at the moment, Counties Manukau, the home side.
Harris holds the ball high. Target again, Retallick. Easy ball in the middle. Driving forward is Elijah Nicholas, who's coming in off that left wing as first receiver a little bit. Yahi Toma. Penalty.
Number nine rollout.
Kane Hansey, the veteran, not getting out of the way. And this would give Dan Hollinshead a nice opportunity dead in front.
Been a tough start to the ITM Cup for this side. Counties Manukau. Still have seen the penalty here, the infringement. Given away, not rolling away. Another chance for Bay of Plenty to extend their lead after an impressive start. Counties Manukau on sitting on second to last behind Manawatu. Early days. It's quite a critical game for them in the ITM Cup competition.
Well, this is interesting. Hollinshead putting it into the corner. You saw where he kicked that from. He wasn't far outside the 22 dead in front. I don't know whether that's a case of not sure on the wind or just supreme confident from the Steamers that they feel they've got the wood on.
Well, it's a good time to do it, though, Nigel. Send a message, get the pack humming. Callum Retallick and Carl Axton's the co-captains in that pack. They're keen to get stuck in.
Harris, Retallick, third time they go to Callum, and he plucks it down nicely, and the Steamers look to get in and drive. Smuggle that ball to the back. Sakalia has it in the caboose. Just keeping the eyes up, peering. Lawrenson tries to reach through and grab him. Inch by inch.
Use it!
You heard the call.
Nine, use it! Listen!
Thomas got to get to that. Richard Kelly saying use it. Well, they can't say they weren't warned, Ben Castle. Richard Kelly very, very clear.
And he was clear. They have two goes at it. He asked for the ball. They were still moving forward.
Just it's have a three tough, goes at it.
Tough rule, but it is the rule. You see Richard Kelly, he's told him to use it here. He's wanting the pill. Callum Retallick's got his hands on the ball. They're still moving forward. He comes around there, number five, into the boot.
He was probably a little bit lenient. He gave him about three or four goes. You can only give him two. But probably another statement from Bay of Plenty, though, Ben, in terms of that drive. Good drive from Bay of Plenty.
You see the numbers there. A lot of turnovers early on. 7-5. 7 for Bay of Plenty. 5 for the home side, Counties Manukau.
Well, they've had a pretty tough week of training at Bay of Plenty. Their coach Clayton McMillan was not impressed after Matthew Cooper. You might have been impressed with Waikato's work last week against Bay of Plenty, but certainly the Steamers head coach was not, and gave them a fairly tough session, fairly honest. He was fairly up front with them all. They missed a lot of tackles last week. This stat here, the Counties head coach won't be too happy, Tana Umanga. But they are taking some confidence into this game up front at Bay of Plenty and really taking it to the Steelers.
Great shot there of the battle between Firth and Sakalia, and Firth dominating. There goes Hansi. Terry's going to be under a bit of pressure. No real net gain for Counties Manukau there. That's good work from Bay of Plenty. Put pressure on. Exit play from Counties Manukau just not executed as cleanly as what they would have liked.
Good scrum though, Ben.
Very good scrum. Yep, very good scrum. Jared Firth on this side.
Harris, and again they go to Retallick. Better counter this time though by Counties Manukau. Bay of Plenty reset once again and start getting on the march. Yahi Toma just sure will have one ear waiting for Kelly. Now they go. Holland's here. Little short ball. Nicholas. Elijah's picked up and dumped. Here comes Retallick. Straightening the attack again, Bay of Plenty. Callum Retallick up the middle to the ground. Over that ball is Taufua. No, that's not Taufua. Excuse me, that's Manu. Under advantage. Ball slow, reaching out. There's a hand. It's down. Sean Edu's getting the congratulations. Second try for Bay of Plenty.
Oh, just reward as well for Bay of Plenty. They've worked hard up front. And off that line out, Callum Retallick. He stood up each line-out they've had so far, taking the ball in. They were patient, they built up well. And the co-captain did the phase before. Sean Edu reached out. Retallick was involved. This is good reward. You can see them here, they're patient, they're set. They were playing under advantage. And then you see the Mitt reach out and score.
Yeah, win the ball.
Oh, this is impressive. This is a very impressive start to Bay of Plenty. After about 10 minutes, there's Sean Edu going over. But what I like about it, Ben, is the structure that Bay of Plenty have come to Pukekohe to play their game. And here comes the kick from Hollings here. That's over. They've got a 14-point lead. Outstanding. But this wonderful structure from this side. As we mentioned, tough week after the big loss. And they've obviously listened to their coach.
Very good opening 16 minutes by the Steamers. Counties Manukau just need to get their hands on the ball. I know it's a cliche, but it's so appropriate.
Well, in the territory, Nigel, is 92% sitting in Bay of Plenty's favour at this point in time.
Here is Nemani, who's had a big role already to play, with Bardell popping the ball over the top. Apatanga with a nice carry. Holland's here. Stick through. Craft. Chemist, turnover, Counties Manukau, that's Fafita, and they're not going to catch Sione, and by George, do the Steelers need that. 17 minutes gone, the home side on the board against the run of play, but so needed, Ben Castle.
Oh, absolutely, and Jordan Taufua working so hard at the breakdown. We're so used to him doing that for either the Crusaders or for Counties Manukau. Here he is over the ball in the number 7. He's fighting for the ball, has the right still to squirt it out, and luckily into Siona Fafita's hands. He's played every minute for the Steelers so far this season. That's a very well-taken try against the run of play.
Well, it is. It's a turnover, and it's well done, isn't it? Taufua in the ruck there on the mall, and the ball comes out. Look at the speed of the big fella, 105 kgs. Fafita just had to show some real clean pair of heels. He's too quick, and a much-needed try. Counties are in for try number one.
There's Jared Page. This will be a very tough kick based on those conditions that we heard Matthew Cooper describe earlier. Aye, the breeze is just going to hold. That's an unconverted try, but a needed try. The advantage cut back down to a 9-point lead by the visitors, Bay of Plenty. Sione Fafita. Johan Bardell. Taufua. I wonder how many times those two will collide into each other over the remainder of this game. Coming forward and taking it nicely is Lawrenson. Hansen. Punches that one up. That'll hold. Coming forward, Tia Tia takes it nicely. Just to get that ball wide to Craft Chemist, and then Nemani out on the full. The option was the right one, Matthew Cooper. It was just execution. He was a bit isolated with no one there, so the idea to put it in behind was probably a good one.
I just like him. I think he's strong, he's powerful, he's offloading, he's breaking the first tackle. Good start.
He's coming to the Chiefs setup very young, did Tino Nemani. from Sewer. Kennedy's enjoying a little bit of territory and possession for the first time in this game. Here's Fifita. Had to wait for that one slightly, but drives forward. Gets good support. Hansey. Short ball. There's Taufua carrying. Edu was waiting for him, though. Firth takes on Holland's head. Equal to the task was the first five. Hansey again. The Terry with a little kick through. It's nice play. An opportunity maybe to put some pressure on the line out of Bay of Plenty.
Yeah, some just building phases, getting their hands on the ball. Our county's Manukau, and they start to play into the area, into Bay of Plenty's territory, the area they need to be. And put some pressure on.
He's holding here.
Tom Retallick. He's called himself. And why not when you're winning everything that's throwing you away? Lovely work. Holland's here. Strong carry there by Caleb Hall, the second 5'8". Now that's come back to County's chance to counter. Taufua. Out it comes to Sua. Oh, gets rid of Nathan Harris. As the two number twos come together. Wide it comes Vaipulu. Well stopped there by Elijah Nicholas, the left wing. Hansey. Keeps that coming left. To Terry. Vang and now Vaka. Hansey again. To Terry. Here it comes to Jimmy Tupor. Vaipulu roaming with him. Good defence though by the Steamers. Here's Manu Radasia. Can they stop him? Yes, they can. Over the ball, Bay of Plenty. Penalty. That's nice work. Getting in and over the ball.
Elijah Nicholas. There, the winger getting over the ball, all the rights to the ball.
Is he bleeding or is he?
But good build up. County's Manukau.
Time out.
Off that turnover, there's some concern. Put a player down.
Is that a good cut or is he need a goal?
Johan Bardol.
Johan Bardol is the man that's down by the looks of it.
Yeah,
blood. By the heavily strapped thighs that he's got.
Well, lucky like there. Good turnover, wasn't it, in the end there? There's the injury, but two poor carries from Bay of Plenty almost ended. The first one ended in a try to Fafita. And Caleb Hall taking the ball a bit upright and got to watch it. If you get turned over by this county's Manukau side, you've got to be very, very careful.
You're running into some big traffic, aren't you, with Jordan Taufua, Mama Vaipulu, Jimmy Tupou even, and the blindside jumper for counties. Here we'll see Rarasea.
Yeah, I think he just copped a stray boot there, just might have come down. Nothing malicious in it. It's just one of those incidents that happen in the game of rugby. And we see him as big Viliame Rarasea comes down. And there and oh yeah, just copped one there.
Absolutely accidental.
Oh yeah, nothing malicious in it at all. But oh right. Let's go again, says the man they call Yogi.
He will not be going anywhere. He will not go anywhere.
Tough as Teague Johan Bardol.
Gee,
could you imagine him? He's a teacher. Could you imagine him walking into class of a Monday morning to say, all right, boys and girls?
Yeah, I haven't done my homework. Johan Baldu, the teacher.
You don't bring him an apple, you bring him a side of beef.
Just wait.
Here's Nathan Harris to feed this line out. Holland's head controlled the game nicely at first five. Dan Holland's head.
I'll give you time to set up. Just like get them on you down the back.
Well, they keep throwing it to Retallick. I think it's five on the trot. They've gone to Bay of Plenty. Make it six. It's easy pickings for Callum today. Here's Holland's head dancing through. Sees a bit of a gap over the gain line. Nice work. Toma, a little bit of interference. They'll come back.
Five, just lying in his way.
That was against Lawrenson.
Just on that, Ben, Callum Retallick, yeah, isn't he a great exponent of the line-out? It was beautiful clean take there, wasn't it? Great camera work too.
Oh, he's a very, very good operator at line-out time. He does a lot of work on the computers, a lot of analysis with his side. He knows exactly where to go. Just one little subtle change in the line-out and up he goes. He's jumping against lifters. He prides himself in the line-out and 87 matches as well, as I mentioned earlier today. And that's not out.
That's been kept in brilliantly. Here is Tiahi Toma, takes that kick. So play still underway. Tia Tia, they've got some width there, Bay of Plenty to work with. Hollenheads is going to put the kick through. Tracking across is Deteri. This time it's gone out. And they will set for the line out.
Lovely play, Dan Hollingshead. Very good footballer. Good, very accurate at goal as well. Just the heads up there. Very similar to Damien McKenzie. I love how those two young 5'8s, they look ahead first. What's my option? Beautiful grubber.
I've seen counties taken down nicely by Lawrence. He did have to reach to get it, but he controlled it nicely. Man in the star-spangled headgear. Hansey. Nick waiting. He's pushed it a bit far. There's some space to work with here. Tia Tia gets it. Wide they come to Nicholas, who steps. He's got support. Looking for the inside. That was Craft Chemis. Axton, inside ball to Nicholas. It's been lost forward. They're running some beautiful lines, Matthew Cooper, these Bay of Plenty backs when they get the opportunity.
You probably just needed, agree, but probably need to just go wide there. Use the width of the park there. You had them behind. You got them behind them. That's a lovely break there too. Good defence from counties.
Both you guys,
just probably needed to go wide again. Use the outsides.
Coming back for a scrum, which will be loose head and feed for Kanis Manukau, who after that rough opening 16 minutes have just settled down a bit now, getting their share of territory and possession. We've seen the territory stat come back from, what was it, 1.92% to 8. It's starting to even itself back out a little bit.
I've clearly stated that I want to ear-to-ear, not pre-engage. And what do? We go straight into pre-engage.
There you go, okay. 70 to 30.
Let's get it right, or I'm going to freak out.
It don't look like much, but there you go. That gives you a better indication. Hollingshead.
Nine. Just wait for me. I'll wait for it to stable first.
The captain, Tupo Mama Vaipulu.
Crouch! Bind!
Vaipulu and Bardell. Very impressive in some of the Chiefs' fitness training that they do and testing. Vaipulu currently with the ball at his feet. Sides is going to get this ball away. Here comes up the tie down the right wing with strong carry. Hansey trying to get himself out of trouble is Kane. He's rolling. They need a half back. Jimmy Tupou says, no, I've got this. They go out. One off carry. Tupou there again. Hansey's up this time, so he'll take his place as halfback. Box kick once again. Waiting is Nicholas. Hakutai. Oh, he gets away, does Elijah. And straightens. And he's away. Elijah Nicholas. Will he need support? Yes, he will. Takes it down, presents. Bodies there for Bay of Plenty. Can they get quick ball? Yes, they can. Hollingshead. Wide. From Chemis. Nemani stepping back. Only a metre or so short. Tiahi Toma diving, scoring. Oh, they're going to have a look. Tiahi Toma, well, he says he's got it.
Right, it's up to you.
He's galloping back.
Well, he's pretty confident.
And you can see it's been awarded. Third try for Bay of Plenty. And they stretch that advantage back out to 14 after 26 and a half minutes.
Well, they had counties, they had the scrum, they had the exit play, the box kick taken fantastically by Elijah Nicholas, and the pressure on him, here he is, Hukatai with the tackle, and then the presence of mind, and off he went, and he was looking for some support, but he did the right thing, then looked after the ball, and a good clean out here, and this is the end, Craft Chemis to drag it in to Marty, thought he could have gone all the way, we'll see Tiahi Toma. The step and then the reach out, and he knew he had got it. It's a good strike from Bay of Plenty.
Oh, geez, biblical terms. The seas parted, didn't they? Absolutely. For Elijah Nicholas, great break. 8 from 8 this year. Big test for the first five.
Staring into that setting sun won't help either. No, unconverted. So the lead stays at 14. Bay of Plenty, very dangerous.
Well, you've got to make your tackles, don't you? And that was the case there for the new man. Here's the final act of the try, over the top. Fair try, number three for Bay of Plenty, outstanding. But Ngātahua Nikitai, the man on debut, make sure of your tackle, because they've just been punished.
We're going to play on. There's a bit of a concern about a Bay of Plenty player, but it's been waved off by the looks of it. Waiting for it is Nemani. Using his solid running to good effect. Holland's here. They're going to keep going here, Bay of Plenty. Now onto the left foot of Tia Tia. Page gets it. Chance for the Steelers to counter-attack. No, puts the kick through. He's found some space here. Sets up nicely, though, for Holland's head. He's taken that back inside the 22. Punches that one down. Fifita tracks back.
Connect, boys, connect.
Taken that. Page will weigh up the options. He decides he's going to have a go and pushes that one out on the full. All the way back they will come. Bay of Plenty. More territory and possession on the back of another mistake by Counties Manukau.
You're just smarter in some of that. Look to go quickly there, but they're just smarter in their kicking. Their contestable kicks. Dan Hollinshead with a lovely raking punt in behind for Fita. And then Jared Page just on his right boot, just too far, and it gives Bay of Plenty exactly what they're after. A line out inside there, or just outside the 22, a short line out.
Here's a quick change to sideline. Tarangi Fraser's on. He's come on for Elijah Nicholas. Might be just going up there for a concussion or a blood test. I'll just check.
Axton with a good carry in midfield while all that was happening. Toma, here comes Holland's head. Wide it comes Tia Tia. Tries to get to the outside and does so. Here's Sean Edder with a beautiful step. Tupou and Hansi, Tupou and Hansi, I should say, combining. Kane goes driving through.
Oh, here.
Pula'apitanga plays halfback. Back out into midfield. Setting this up nicely, Bay of Plenty. Counties Manukau trying to get over the top. That ball coming back, very slow. Here it is. Pick and go. Johnny Cormack continues to organise. There's Honick. Pops that ball up. Shoulder to the grindstone. Here's Toma once again. Hollinshead with a little chip through. Diving and scoring. Too easy. That is, I think, the man that's come on, Tarangi Fraser.
It is Tarangi Fraser. Bay of Plenty, what a try. Well set up. Hollinshead with a little kick in behind. He summed it up beautifully, but hard work from the forwards initially. Off the line out, a big carry from Carl Axton's in midfield. And then the forwards got into their work, and everything's over the advantage line. There's Tala'apitanga taking it forward, and then they went to go, and Holland's head on the boot, and no one home, and that's a very well-taken try. Wow, Bay of Plenty, unstoppable.
Well, he might go off shortly, because he's replacing Elijah Nicholas for a concussion test. There he is, Tarangi Fraser, a good footballer at fullback for Bay of Plenty when he starts the game. But you mentioned smart football. I'll tell you what, Dan Hollingshead's having a ripper of a game. Like him. First five here. Chance to get the conversion. You mentioned smart. They're urgent. They really want this game. Playing well, Bay of Plenty.
Hollingshead trying to convert the bonus point try. Misses. One of the only things you could probably get him for is maybe the accuracy off the boot, but a bonus point for Bay of Plenty already. Just under 32 minutes gone, 8 to play until half time.
Oh, just heady football. They're up real flat, and I love seeing that first five just dribble the ball through the grubber, through taking the courage, the risk to put it in behind the dead ball. Lovely try.
We start the Terry. Coming forward to take it is Nemani. With a little bit of a goose before he goes into contact. Toma, Hollinshead. Why'd they come onto the left boot? Charging through there. That's Paul now spinning around. Head down, driving through. There's Deteri. Hansi. Comes away to Vaka. Tries to dribble that ball through. Comes up a Bay of Plenty player, though. There's Tiahi Tomo's having a cracking wee game, the halfback.
Keep that gap.
The line-out throw, though, for Counties Manukau, who had just started to work their way back into the game, Ben, before conceding those two quick tries.
And they're off from stakes, and that's what will kill counties, and they'll get that message no doubt at half time. But just some silly mistakes, kicking out on the full, giving Bay Penny another line out to attack from. And now they do have the pill to attack, and away they go.
Wide ball off the nice line out, charging their way into the Bay of Plenty defence, which has been as good as the offence.
Nice tackle!
Hansey is under advantage. Hansey squashed to the ground. And as Manukau continue to advance though, 2-4. Vaienga, the Teddy. Oh, intercept, they'll come back, it's under advantage. And Tiatia knew it was under advantage too.
No clear release.
Well, that's fortunate.
Mark here.
Nathan Harris penalised at the breakdown. Just not rolling away.
Looks as though Elijah Nicholas on the left wing for Bay's passed his test. He's pretty keen to get back out there, especially after his mates just scored a try.
I was about to say, the comment between Tarangi Fraser and Elijah Nicholas as they run past each other, I think would be quite good to be able to hear.
Yeah, so there's the wide pass there, the intercept. Yep, Tarangi just looked up and says, me, am I going off? After what I've just done, but yep, he's off. The left wing said, get off, I want another go.
Staying here.
There is Elijah Nicholas.
I'll let you
call comes in. They go to 2-4, reaches up and takes it beautifully. The counties decide to set the drive and they've lost that ball. Chance for Bay of Plenty to counter-attack if they so desire. Honick tries to get it wide. Nemani just reaches out and plucks it back in before putting boot to ball. Page. Did he keep that in? Yes, he did. And runs back into Nemani, who's advanced up in defence. Penalty.
Clear
not
release.
Releasing the call.
Clear release.
So Nathan Dettetti will look to punch this ball down the left-hand side.
It's another mistake, isn't it? If we go back to the drive, the counties were well set. They made another mistake in a turnover, allowing Bay of Plenty back in. It's a crucial time of the game, just before half-time, 5 minutes leading in. They're going to need some points here, 24-5 down.
So, Sua. Waiting for his target. They go to the back. It's overthrown. And here's Harris. Harris with the left-footed kick through.
Well, Finn, that's just another case, isn't it? It's almost like another turnover, isn't it? And that's been the story of the game for the counties, Manukau, the home side, in the first 40. Disappointing accuracy. The urgency's not there. And the visiting team have just proved, you know, how urgent they are. They want how much they want this game.
Sua waits for the call.
Just wait for it to be over.
That's better. Lawrenson takes it down.
Now it's over.
Walking it forward. Hansey, box kick. Straight up. Pinkin. Down it comes to Kalfua. They will be penalised there.
All inside the 10.
Yeah, halfback kicks it straight up.
Shot.
That sort of penalty was always going to come. And I'm trying to see what decision Bay of Plenty make. Looks as though Holland said it's going to take a shot at goal.
Oh, interesting. Their line out is humming and their forward pack's humming, but possibly a chance for a breather. Just
well, it'd just be another hammer, wouldn't it, if he nails this from 40-odd metres. Goes into the break at around 27 points to 5. Jeez, what a 40. They've been good though, haven't they? Just in terms of their urgency, their attitude. Got real structure to their game too, the Steamers.
Yeah, they've come here with a job to do, it seems. They've, after a pretty tough week, as we've mentioned, and counties, though, on the other hand, they've had a shorter week. They were playing Wednesday night, so fatigue could be creeping in. They've had less training time.
So, Hollinshead. A bit of length to this kick. Nice off the boot.
He likes it.
And that's wide. That's a lovely kick by Dan Hollinshead. The advantage now out to 22 points.
Okay, thank you.
Interesting stat that's just come through from our statistical guru, Paul Naser. In the last 2 hours here at Ecolite Stadium in Pukekohe, The Steelers have been outscored 62-16 by championship opposition. Harris with the carry.
Release.
So driving forward. Back it comes. Holland's head. Wide they go. Using the left foot of Tia Tia this time. Very good exit play that they've been utilising well. Page. Vaipulu. Comes into the defensive line, which was well formed by Bay of Plenty. And have lost it again. Well, I hope they've lined the walls of the county's Manukau changing room with some pretty good soundproofing, because Tana Umanga, I think, has got every right to really go in and tear strips off his team at half time, because it is just basic stuff, Ben Castle. It's inexcusable at this level.
Well, it's very good play from Bay of Plenty, but it's basic play from Bay of Plenty. That is a simple exit strategy move. Chase Tete onto the left foot. But what I really like about that play is their chase line. They're all coming up, they're all making their tackles, and they're contesting at the breakdown and forcing the mistake. And this is why we are
Look at them talking too, Ben. See, you know, just they're all the energy, the, and that's an attitude thing as well. And one team's brought real attitude, the others a fair bit behind at the moment.
So as we're in the final minute of this half, it's another good opportunity. There's a bit of space out to the right of that scrum. And that's where they want to go. Toma. Little chip through. Tia Tia it was. Couldn't regather. Diteri turns. Kenny's Manukau with an opportunity to try and counter. Here's Taufua. Great surge. Hansi. Puliasi Manu. Getting well over the gain line. Hansi again. They keep looking to come wide. Baka. Poor pass. Going back and having to get that one is Hakutai. Have they turned that one over again, Bay of Plenty? No. County's Manukau. Why? Keep forward.
It's carried back. Carried
Hansi
back.
Back to the Terry. Going to put this one.
Halt, stop.
And it sits up nicely for Hollinshead. And more opportunity to attack. And off he goes. With a little kick through. Chasing through Tia Tia. If it stays in, it doesn't. Beats everyone over the sideline.
Do you have a flagging? Do you have a flagging? Time out. Just wait. I've got a flagging.
Well, it says half time.
Can we just wait? I've got a flagging over here.
There's a flag from the assistant referee.
I don't know what.
Let's just wait and see what it is all about. The sides congregate as the conference takes place.
In the sequence of play just here, I did not get the blue number, but a no-arm tackle against the county's player here. So.
No-arm tackle, but you got no number?
No, I did not get the number.
Okay, so you're saying it's just a penalty here?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. No-arm tackle against you guys, but unfortunately the touch AR hasn't got a number, so I'm just going to give a penalty against you guys here.
Okay. There we go, Jimmy. So penalty.
No, time's up, so you either tap or you kick it out for half-time.
Yeah, you hear the call from Kelly. Let's have a look.
What are we doing?
Oh, Nemani it was.
Yeah.
It's loaded up. Half time it is. Half time in Bay of Plenty with a excellent advantage by 27 points to 5. And they have been very, very efficient. And one guy at the heart of it's Tino Nemani. He's with Matthew Cooper. We head down to him right now.
Well, Tino, outstanding first 40 from the Bay. 4 tries already. Be a pretty happy team talk at halftime.
Yeah, no, I think we've done the good job playing down there, the basics. So I think we'll just keep the pressure down there and then try to get some more points.
You look very good, ball in hand. Same again.
Yeah, we'll just keep working, doing the little things right.
Good on you, well done.
Happy Father's Day.
Hey, even time for the shout-out. There's Poppy, who's not watching the game, and you don't blame. Let's head out. Bay of Plenty in a good spot. Half time, 27-5. Back shortly.
Pass the ball.
It's our spirit! It's our sound.
It's our power.
It's our game.
The ITM Cup, Wednesday and Thursday, Sky Sport 1.
Your empire is how the world will remember you. It's where your dreams come to life. But you must not delay. Plan quickly, build quickly, or be destroyed quickly. Will you build an empire that lasts forever? Will you be my hero? Game of War. Play for free now from the App Store.
There's something in our primary sector that can grow everything. It's growing Anaru's career prospects and Blair's management skills. It's growing Lance's sense of pride and Duncan's productivity. It's also growing our industry and New Zealand. It's the one thing that grows everything. Knowledge. Find out how industry training can provide you with the knowledge to grow.
Rugby World Cup's in the UK.
Swing low, sweet chariot.
Make every match a winner with TAB's One Punt at a Million competition. That's $1 million up for grabs if you pick the outcome of all 48 matches. Free to enter at onepunt.co.nz. TAB, are you in?
I looked under chairs. I looked under tables. I tried to find the key to 50 million fables. They call me the Seeker. To get what I'm after till the day I die.
Get your happy face on with Slingshot's 80 gig naked broadband plan. It's just $65 a month. Call 0800 89 6000 now and be happy at Slingshot.
Immerse yourself in the sound of speed with Formula One. The Italian Grand Prix, live tonight, Sky Sport 4.
A very efficient first half by Bay of Plenty. See them leading by 27 points to 5. They've already got the bonus point as well. Still got 40 minutes to go, and of course Counties Manukau is a team that is more than capable of rattling up points in a heck of a hurry, but they are going to have to improve a lot. It was a great start being castled by Bay of Plenty, who just controlled beautifully and were well rewarded after 4 minutes.
Oh, they got underway, and Nemani with the ball in hand, and Chase Tiatia, man, has already scored 3 tries, well, now over for his 4th. He's in fantastic form, and he got the Bay underway with a great start.
And then it was the turn of the forwards, who just chugged straight up the middle. Few pick and goes, and you're looking for the man wearing the number 6 jersey. There he is, Sean Edu, about to reach in, grab the ball, and he's just going to pop around, put that big left hand out and dot it down. And the advantage was at 14-0 after 16.
And the forwards got involved again, but there was some good breakout work. Yeah, well, this was Counties Manukau with some turnover work from Jordan Taufua. And Fifita, Sione Fifita, just too fast on that side, but that was only all of County's points in that first half.
Yeah, try was unconverted, and then it was back to some more wonderful counter-attacking play by Bay of Plenty. That's Elijah Nicholas starting the next scoring movement. Good strong carry, and in the end it was some good awareness by Tiahi Toma. He dives over in the corner. That was the third try, 27 minutes into this game. It didn't take long for them to get the bonus point try, Ben.
No, probably the best try of the match so far. Just Holland's head sums up beautifully. And Te Rangi Fraser, who came on for an injury substitution and pounced on that ball. Well, it's a very good half of rugby for Bay of Plenty.
Tana Umanga, very calm and cool. I'm sure there'll be a little bit of frustration from Tana. And this is some of the reasons why. Territory, very much dominated by Bay of Plenty. Possession, relatively even, but it's that missed tackle count, Ben Castle. Bay of Plenty know all about that from last week. This week it's the Steelers issue.
Well, 27-5 with 11 missed tackles. That's why there's only 5 on the board. It does tell you a story, though. Stats tell you one side, and the other side is that Bay of Plenty really are just here to play. Their attitude has been better. They've been ferocious at the breakdown. And you see their coach there, Clayton McMillan,
Yeah, Clayton McMillan having a bit of a chat. Joelle Vendieri. It is Joelle Vendieri Tribute Day. Yes, the number 14 jersey, red, white and black. Oh, didn't he cause some absolute mayhem back in the day? Still got 40 minutes to go. Can the modern day Steelers do what Joelle and co used to do? They've got a bit of work. Back shortly, we'll find out.
Body was discovered crushed under his own car.
And it won't be the last.
If it's the same person, they're getting desperate.
Once the chain is in motion, it's unstoppable.
Weekend Murders, Lewis. Tonight, Prime.
Rugby World Cup's in the UK.
Swing low, sweet chariot.
Make every match a winner with TAB's One Punt at a Million competition. That's $1 million up for grabs if you pick the outcome of all 48 matches. Free to enter at onepunt.co.nz. TAB, are you in?
How do you eat your laughing cow cheese? Do you spread it, dip it, or simply snack it? Full of dairy goodness. The Laughing Cow Cheese. Snack your way.
Thanks to your vote, Still Shop is once again home of the most trusted brands. And because that means a great deal to us, it means a great deal for you. Get up to $160 off selected Still tools. Trade up to selected Massport President mowers and receive $50 trade-in. And get $500 off selected Rover ride-on mowers. For these great deals and more, get into your local Steel Shop today. Steel Shop. Love your land.
Whatever your job throws at you, Apparel Master has got you covered. Workplace, rental and laundry solutions. Just Google Apparel Master, the masters of your trade.
Feb 6 and 7, turn your weekend into the greatest weekend.
Don't miss all 16 NRL clubs over one knockout weekend. Live at Eden Park.
Can you believe that?
Two-day tickets from $69 and kids half price.
The greatest names ahead of the greatest weekend.
I'll see you at the 9.
Turn your weekend into the greatest weekend.
The Dixman NRL Auckland Nines, Feb 6 and 7. Book now at Ticketek.
New York is known for its draw cards.
Oh, wow.
A city that's fast, loud, and brash.
Unbelievable.
The US Open, live on Sky Sports. Check guides for times.
County's Manukau find themselves down by 22 points at half-time. Let's find out what Tana Umanga thinks. He's downstairs with Matthew Cooper.
Well, thanks, Nigel. Tana, probably be one of your direct team talks at half-time.
Yeah, it's pretty simple, really. We're lacking a bit of urgency to do things, and we got a bit shell-shocked there at the start. So, we've got 40 minutes to turn around. You know, we've got the wind behind us now, and we've got to make use of that.
Balance between running it fast but also structure?
Yeah, it is. It is. You know, I think, like I said, they put a bit of pressure on us, and we made a few errors inside our half. So, again, that pressure mounted, and it's about our boys making sure they can take care of that.
Hope it goes well.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Yeah, Tana Umanga, very cool, calm, and collected. Very simple message. Let's see now whether his charges can execute. Wait for the second half to get underway. And we've seen a change. Looks as though it's Willie Walker. We'll talk about that a little bit shortly too, but there has been a change at first five. Here's Hollins here. Right to Tiatia. Great hands to get that ball away. There's Elijah Nicholas working down that left wing side. He's been very good. Jahi Toma. Tiatia at first receiver. Talek, Hollins head. Nemani. Eru ranging wide, stepping back through. Flung to the ground by Vaipulu. Good start to the second half again by Bay of Plenty. Trying to get over that ball is Rarasia. Has he turned it over? No. Toma. Up and under. P. punching through, waiting, taking it nicely as Walker. Back it goes to Page.
Come out, Red.
He pushes that ball up high. And by Hollins here. Gets it out to Nemani. Little kick into space. Out on the full. May have to put that one back in the bag of tricks. Yeah, not his time in the game.
Not his best work, Nigel, was it? He's had a very good 40, but there are changes. He's changed the 9 and 10 combo for County, so he's got 20 Sam Henwood, and you mentioned Willie Walker on at first five to replace Nathan Dethery and Kane Hudson.
Taken down by Rarasia. Here is Talfour. 21 is on, and that is Richard Judd. So they've changed the halfback and first five combination. Good strong surge. Presented nicely for Judd. It comes now to Vaka trying to step his way through. Has that been turned over? And it has. Bay of Plenty. Flicked away. Tieter in at first receiver. Hollins head wide. The different options. That was Hall pushing it through. If it sits up, and it does. Kraft Chemis. Can he get rid of that ball? No, he can't. Ball goes back to Toma. Gets it wide. Nemani. Nemani to Bardul, back inside to Axton's. Firth over, can't do it. Sakalia, advantage, penalty.
Offside.
Well, I think you'd have to say, Famotu Kraft Chemis, who comes with great raps out of Gisborne Boys High School. Oh, if he'd given that, you'd think it would have been five and another cracking start to the half for Bay of Plenty.
What are we doing?
Well, it's a perfect start, isn't it? They get underway. Like this, throwing the ball around, just picking up where they left off after the first half. And work at the breakdown here, the turnover. Look at Johan Bardul, strong. Just ripping it clear. And then a good option here. A nice chip. And then the bounce of the ball just pops up. And Kraft Chemis, who is looking for support.
How well's the grubber work today, Ben? I mean, there's been three or four grubbers from the Bay of Plenty side. Just an unused art of the game. The little nudge through where there's a bit of space, and there's the penalty. Oh, I love the grubber.
Well, I think what it is, Matthew, is it's the recognition because the space is there because Counties Manukau are pushing up and leaving those gaps open.
And a lot of that's what defences do now too, so it's another change too. We have had that change with Elijah Nicholas has come off, and the try scorer, Tarangi Fraser, he's got back on there.
We had a good first half, didn't he, Elijah Nicholas? A good game.
Hollins head, that's a great kick. And Bay of Plenty open the scoring in the second half.
Well, Ben, I'm just starting to think of the word clinical, and that's, you know, you're trying to work out attitude, whatever it is. There's been all that urgency, but gee, it's been clinical.
Oh, 30 to 5.
There you go. Willie Walker made his provincial debut last century, Ben Castle. You could still go for 50 if you needed to, Ben. Get back out and hit the roads. Here comes, mind you, Bay of Plenty don't need you today the way they're going. Here is Te Ahi Toma, who's had a very good game at the base of this scrum, I should say, for Bay of Plenty. Back onto the right foot. Punching it forward was Fraser. Vaipulu. This one away to Page, who's looking for Mama. And they've got some space, and he's away. Vaipulu needs support. Presents well. Tupor, way it comes to Lawrenson. Taken down. Counties Manukau. Judd. Ball flung into Vaipulu. There's a counter-attack opportunity for the Steamers wide. Axton's great spot tackle. That was Carter Fainga coming out of the line. Needed to make that. Wide it comes to Retallick. Trying to go straight and hard. They're not sure what to do. They just straighten things up nicely, Bay of Plenty. Fraser, Hollins here. Back to Fraser once again. Hall, Axton, to Fraser. Wide it goes. That's Tia Tia to the outside. They take the feet out from under him and bring him into touch. Just some lovely interplay by Bay of Plenty, and the confidence is just oozing out of them, Ben Castle.
And three red.
Well, they're bringing some reinforcements on both sides, but they are good with ball in hand. Here's the end of it, Chase Tear Tear. It's good defence from Sam Vaka.
Yeah, the big changes are in the front row. Sione
Anga Alangi, he's come on for Gafastasa Sua, yep. And 18 Sam Iano, he's gonna replace number 3 Jared Firth.
See, yep. Jared
come on.
Scrummed very well. You can see the frustration etched on his face, though, can't you? Messy ball, and it's Bay of Plenty with it once again. Honick careens into the opposition. Toma, wide, Hollingshead, Hall, little show. Can he get the hands free? No. Tafu is over that. Toma, back it goes left. Beautifully picked up. Kala'a Apitanga, beautiful hands. Toma again, Hollingshead, as Bay of Plenty just looked to build. Spinning out of that tackle. Honick smuggles it back. Nemani at halfback, Hollingshead. Retallick, they use him a bit in midfield. Sakalia lost that ball forward. Now counties Manukau. Judd. That ball up to Leonor.
Advantage over.
Judd. Wide it comes. Walker. Pushes it in behind using that breeze. Breaks nicely. Beautiful kick. Willie Walker. Lovely piece of experience shown by the man who played. See if I can get them all.
Number 9.
North Harbour, Otago, has spent a bit of time at Bay of Plenty as well. Was a New Zealand Māori representative too. Played for the Highlanders. I think I've got them all.
Just getting to hold the ball.
A couple overseas too, I think, as well. But yep. There is a change there. You can see John Oketo, the Bay halfback, coming on for Tiahi Toma, the try scorer, scored the third try. And he's played very well too.
Yeah.
Toma's been excellent this afternoon. Not a bad replacement in a former New Zealand under 20 player. And it's counties Manukau with the steal. Short it comes to Manu. Quickly on to him. And Alangi waits. And it's Manukau just trying to build. Reaching in. Eono. It's worked by Sam. But oh no, he's lost it. Harris onto the left foot. He's been very keen to show that left foot, Nathan Harris. If he'd kept it in play, though, that would have been very interesting.
Good work at the breakdown, Bay of Plenty. They turned that line out over. They managed to fight back and get that ball. More subs.
Well, it happens, doesn't it? We're a team that's well behind. And there's Bay of Plenty in the mix there. Turnover again. Coming out. Very physical up front of Brazier for the Bay forwards. So the change is Avilamani Rarosia being replaced by Silakila Nabor, the man famous for scoring that big try against Hawke's Bay for a Shield win a few years back.
Smuggled back. Jard inside ball. Taufua! Big jaunt. Oh, just short. He presents well. Judd. Oh, that is going to be. Well, that's pure cynical play.
Yeah, the hand will. Could that be a penalty try?
I don't think it's a penalty try because there was cover.
Let's just have a look at this.
Okay,
we'll get a look, I'm sure, because they're going to bring in the television match official, you suspect.
Yeah.
Here we go. We'll talk with the assistant referee first.
Okay.
Definitely a bit terrific.
Yeah, he's used no arms. Do you reckon there was cover? Or do we need a check to see whether a possible penalty try?
Yeah, worth a check.
Okay, Glenn.
So,
Glenn.
Richard Kelly.
Yeah.
Some Blackwell and says, let's go and have a look.
Blue. I just want to see if that prevented a probable try, please.
So there you go. So they are checking for the possibility of a penalty try. And that is what is under
and
review at the moment.
Just confirm the number for me while you're at it.
Johan Bardul will be sitting down. Let's have a look. Great work, first of all, by Taufua. Wide it comes. So there's a shoulder. Well. Cover. I don't actually know, was there anyone outside of Lawrenson?
Anyway,
he's 2 metres tall.
Well, there was
a few steps.
There was cover. I don't think there was any counties player out. I don't think you could award that as a penalty try, could you, gentlemen?
Well, Sean Oru, isn't he? He's the one that's covering with it. It could be the slight bit of doubt that he could have got there.
I think it's.
Yeah, Glenn.
Let's listen. as they come down. Message coming through to Richard Kelly.
Penalty against 4 Blue.
There you go, penalty against 4 Blue. Thank this you. Will be a yellow card as well for Johan Bardal.
Give me a yellow card as well. Yep. Just penalty.
Johan knew it.
Just a penalty, Jimmy.
Yep. Zico's galloping off.
What are you going to do? Scrum.
So it'll be a penalty. Scrum.
Scrum.
And a 1-man advantage for Counties Manukau for the next 10 minutes and how vital these 10 minutes could be.
Yeah, we get the break here. Here's Jordan Tafua. So he started it. Powerful. He just set up Tirangi Fraser, who made a very good tackle at the end. And here was the ball.
Come on.
Oh, it's tough. Tough for Counties. That was their opportunity. Penny are not off the hook. They are a man down up against a good scrum.
Let's go, Locks.
Well, here's that question. Do you take one of your outside backs and use them as a full eight? Or do you back your seven?
Bind!
Against the eight of Counties Manukau. Counties have been scrummaging very well. One of the few bright points of their game so far. Here comes the pressure. Held at the back by Vaipulu. Marching towards. Here comes Judd. Judd's just going to dive through and score under advantage. And so straight away they take advantage of that one-man advantage that they have. Very key score for Counties Manukau.
Yeah, well done, Counties. A good time to score and a very good scrum. Yes, Bo Penny, a man down, but it takes some skill to control that ball. Mama Vaipulu at the back. Here it is. The weight comes on. We are 8-7. Vaipulu at the back does well to control it. It nearly gets away on him, but he keeps hold of it there. And then Axton's joins the scrum, and this is where Judd picks up and goes over.
I'll answer your question. They should have put somebody in there, Nigel. They should have put Chase Tiatia in there and brought another player over to cover that blind because that was just too dominant. Well constructed, but too dominant. Good try there and deserved because of the foul, you know, of the foul play.
Here's Page. Kicks it very high, but it's through. And those 2 points, vital.
Well, they brought the reinforcements on, haven't they, Counties? So it's a good reward. They're back in this match. They are known to score points all throughout an 80-minute game. Would not be in. Oh, Johnny Fauli on now. A good young talent in the midfield.
Yeah, Fauli's come on. He's replaced number 11, Sione Fafatia, the try scorer.
Reached out. Getting up there, and Bay of Plenty have claimed that. I think it's Chase Tiatia. Kitter with Talek. They continue to work this way through the back line. Holland's here. Here's Nemani trying to get the hands free. Still going, Tino. Flicks the ball over the top. Did that ball go forward? No, it didn't. The call, it does come through eventually.
Thank you.
Took a wee bit of time for the call to come in from the sideline, but eventually it did.
Sorry, guys, I needed a call.
So Richard Kelly just explaining that he needed that communication to come in from his assistant referee. And so it's going to be a scrum. Nemani has been very, very strong in midfield for Bay of Plenty. Just a wee knock on there. There he is. Tino Nemani. He's been running opposite him. Tony Fauli will have the red headgear on. Willie Walker, good to see you back.
Let's go, Lodge. Crouch.
See what backline move they have got set. As you suspect that Counties will be looking to run.
Set.
Now by 18. Good scrum, as they should have. Vaipulu, Judd. Coming for the big strong, big carry into contact. Wider comes Walker with the big up and under. Taking it nicely as Fraser. Looking at his options, beats one before he gets taken by Mitupo. Kitto, Nemani, inside ball to Hall. He gets it to Kitto. The interplay, just the little subtle stuff from Bay of Plenty has been very nice to watch this afternoon. Counties try and counter dry. It comes to Tarangi Fraser. Nice hands by Retallick, but had to go back for it. Well behind the gain line as they push him back to halfway. Kitto looking blindside. That's where he goes, stepping. That's Kraft Kimmis. Over the top of that ball, I think. Has that been turned over by Nabu? Oh, Bay of Plenty still have it. Kitto. Tanga presents well. Kitto. Hollins here. Sees space back over to that left-hand side. Page has read it well, though, and takes. To punch that ball down the right-wing side. Namani's back. Over the shoulder. Unfazed by it. Very relaxed. Tarangi Fraser. Good long kick taken by Vaipulu just outside the 22. Walker. Now they get this ball out wide. Ball in one hand to the outside. That's Vaka. Little kick through. And it's taken by Hollinshead. This is play on. Hollinshead. Has he got the speed? He tries to use the step. Going back as Fowley. Pops the ball up to Harris. He loses it into contact. And it's going to be a knock on against Nathan Harris. Great awareness by Dan Hollinshead, though. Ball ricocheting.
Oh, well, Sam Vaka, here he is, ball in one hand. Part of the All Black Seven setup this year. Look at him, just on the outside. And just saw Dan Hollinshead. The fortunate bounce, and then the pace just didn't quite have it. It's a good covering work from Jared Page. And follow up, John Fauli, and then Nathan Harris. Oh, just unfortunately losing the ball in contact. A good hustle, good recovery from Counties Manukau.
A bit of change to captain Jimmy Tupu. The Counties Manukau captain at number six has been replaced by Sam Henwood.
No, I'm good, thanks.
Nathan Harris, Ben, going well, isn't he? Good to see him back after that horrific injury in Chicago last year. Seems to be going very well at hooker.
Stay off the scrum.
Yeah, an abrasive player, Nathan Harris. Two tests now. Back with the Chiefs for a couple of seasons. It's good to see him getting some rugby.
Signed that extension as well. That's going to be a heck of a battle, though, for that hooking spot at the Chiefs next year, because Hicker Elliott's gone exceedingly well. We've still got the likes of Quentin McDonald and Reese Marshall. Either of those two players come back.
Let's go, Lox.
So scrum about to form. Crash! Inside County's Manukau territory.
Bind! Set!
Digging his feet in. Another good scrum. And away the ball goes. Using Barker. Walker flings it out wide. It sits up nicely for Page. Player down as well for
Willie Walker.
It is Willie Walker. Ball bounces out, but there's a player in backfield who is down, and it is Willie Walker. Maybe is thinking right now, maybe coming back wasn't the best idea. He took a heck of a shunt, the 37-year-old.
Yeah, he got it from Tino Namani. I just want to have a look at the arms. Are there arms in the tackle?
No.
Right on the point of the shoulder.
Yeah.
You could say there was an attempt.
Who's in? Three or four?
Very, very weak attempt, though, Matthew, if we're being generous there. Here's Kitto. Hollinshead. Oh, there's Fowley. What a strong shot. Great work by Axton's, though. He took the hit and still got up to the 22. Penalty against Counties Manukau. Jordan Talfua not happy with the call.
Oh, what a collision. Johnny Fauli in the midfield. Just 19 years old, this Jordan Talfua.
A real shame, Willie Walker. First time out in the county's colours. Coming off the field.
There is Johnny Fauli. No, but you're right, Coops. Willie Walker does not look comfortable. Looks like an AC joint.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's Hollinshead. Oh. Holding that left shoulder, 37 years of age. You'd like to see those players still around, because the experience of a 37-year-old with all of his travels, all that he's been through in his life, be so good for a young side. Here comes Bay of Plenty through Retallick. Hollins here. Continue to work away. Apitanga, Hall. He's grafted away nicely at second five today. There's Caleb Hall. Holland's here. Now, will this sit up for Page? Yes, it does. Fucker was wrapping around. Page crabbing across field a little bit. Okudai driving forward. Hasn't seen much of the play. He's not though up. Why will that sit up? It does for Vaka. Now they get it up to Vainga. Back inside again to Vaka. Still going. Flicks the ball back to Nemani. Gets rid of Vainga. Back to Holland's head. Just that one forward. Does it land out on the fall? They're going to have to come all of the way back.
Watch the ball. It's still alive.
So Nathan Dethery's back on now to replace Willie Walker, the injured player.
That's the changes. Only Sean Bagshaw is the only player left for Counties Manukau on the bench.
Who's in the receiver?
Vaka, when he gets the opportunity, he's shown the talent that he's got.
2 metres.
On the Aolangi. The throw to the line out. Taken down nicely by Lawrenson. They sack him quickly. Manu. And ball with the clear out. Aono. Diving on that one is Taufua. Here comes good strong carry by Sione on the Aolangi. Manu head down driving.
Onside.
He waits again. On the Aolangi wants to go. No. Gets it out to Taufua, who's got good support. It's Henwood who's come on in jersey 20. This is nice stuff by Counties Manukau. There is Sam Henwood. Spinning and driving forward. There's Nambo, I think it was, with the carry. Still going. Big clean outs. Straight up the middle. Aolangi again. Gee, he's been active in this phase. Lawrenson. Vaipulu waits for the ball, but no, it's another pick and another go.
Turnover's good.
And it's been turned over. All that work for Nout. And now Page. Off a poor kick. Page to the outside. Outnumbered. Needs support. Gets it there. Baoli over the top as well. Counter drive by the Bay. And they've got through. Harris. Baoli. They're driving him towards the sideline. They get him out.
Okay, easy. Easy.
Wanting to go quickly is Baoli. No, they will come all the way back.
Well, interesting option after the turnover. Bay Penny, they're rolling out. There's more substitutions, Coops.
Yeah, they are. The whole three coming on there. So the naughty boys come back, Baldo, and he'll be pleased. There was only 7 points in that turnaround. This is the turnover here from Bay of Plenty, and which led to this line out. So changes. We've got Seb Sikitanga. He's come on now for Nathan Harris. Tupou's come off now. Sean Ito's come off, replaced by Joe Tupou. And the last one is Nick Evermy. He's on for the star of the show for Bay of Plenty, Tino Nemani.
There is Ongi Aolangi. Hasn't Sione made an impact for Counties Manukau? Ball out the back. And it's the skipper, Carl Axton, the co-skipper, charging away. Kito. Holland's here. Onto that right foot. It's a big punt. Vaka waits. Sam's got space. And throws a pass that sits up nicely for Page to the defensive line. Panova. Back it comes Judd. Manu. Aono. Here is Nambo. He's just moving to touch. You just suspect Ben Castle. All it's going to take is just one. Just one little inside ball to stick. Counties Manukau could make this final 20 minutes very interesting.
There's the Counties Manukau bench all being loaded onto the field with number 17, Sean Bagshaw, replacing Tuliasi Manu.
So here's Siatanga, Seb Siatanga, jersey 16 here, wants the gap. Bit of a struggle, battle. Counties Manukau have stolen that one as well.
Yeah, good hustle at line-out time. Counties on defence. Using Carl Axton's very good jumper at the front of the line-out, but Counties up to the mark. We need to get that ball possibly back in Callum Retallick's hands.
Well, I was going to say, why would you have gone away? I think Retallick won, was it about 8 or 9 in a row in the first half? Just keep throwing it to him. Remember, Wellington won an NPC title just by Norm Hewitt throwing it to Dion Waller 17 times a game. It works. If they can't stop it.
I think Counties at halftime, they did their homework. They did some analysis in the shed. Their forwards coach, Grant Henson, possibly figured out Retallick's plans.
Scrum forms. Here's Hensy waiting. Vaka's come away to this left-hand side. Sorry, that is Judd. Excuse me. Kane Hensy substituted off a wee while ago. My apologies. Here is Lawrenson. This is under advantage. See the arm extended here by referee Kelly. As Counties continue to just slowly work their way up to the 22. It's Kelly Nambor taken down. They're going to go back and play that penalty.
Yeah, the penalty for Axton's. They're both off the scrum.
Two things. One stays straight and second binding.
Yep. Yeah, the binding call there at that scrum. Very good scrum from Counties again. And their forwards are certainly on a rumble, so hence they've opted for this. You see scrum time here. Look at the back there. Honnock's up. Axton's are up. The binding. They're not binding anywhere. That's what they've been pinged for. And now a real opportunity.
Langi with a nice line-out throw. Complete reversal. The county's line-out is beautiful at the moment. Bay of Plenty's has gone to the Dogs. Good drive. Good surge. Great present. Scoop and pick out. You're just five out. Bagshaw it was. Langi has just been into everything since he's come on. Henwood to Bagshaw. Still going and crawling.
Yeah, he can't carry on. No, offside.
Well, they cleared the path for him. It was a nice try by Bagshaw.
Scrum.
Well, their scrum is in that good a shape. This is a perfect opportunity for them. Here we get their forwards starting to rumble. There's the all piling in. Their substitute, their bench has been very good, hasn't it, Coops? They've all come on. They've all contributed.
Just got to hold it down.
Well, that'd be wild. I mean, as he crawls over the line there, old Bagshaw, that'd be wild. They'd be wanting to go.
When you're under pressure, okay?
Just being too individual, Ben. They're just being, they've lacked structure to their game. Of course, they've come up across a very good visiting side who did have structure, they did have urgency. And it's still obviously a fair way to go. Well, it's interesting, too. And out of they've played 56 times, these two teams. Counties Manukau have won 28 of those. Bay of Plenty have won 27, and there's been one draw. So Bay of Plenty come out on top tonight. They'll equal the ledger.
Well, let's look back to a game from 2012 as we flash back. Counties Manukau dominant on that particular night. Charging through. Galloped away. That was a big victory for the Steelers back in 2012.
Sorry, guys. What are we doing?
Retallick, he'll be... Well, still a little concerned with 16 and a half to go. It's 18 points.
I've been told. Time's off.
And they really have been under the cosh recently. When we look at the territory and possession stats, Counties Manukau have really evened things up. Here comes Tiahi Toma back on because of the injury to...
Caleb Hill. Caleb Hall's come off with a hand injury. So what happens to there? We're going to have to...
Well, Tiahi Toma can actually play first five, so he'll probably go in at pivot, I would suspect. I'll just wait and see how this all shakes down.
Look for a big county scrum here.
Judd. Held at the back. Away they come. Here's Faoli. Taken down, five out. Here is Henwood. Judd. Short ball. Defensive line from Bay of Plenty is held pretty well for the most part. Player flung out of the ground. Judd, short ball. Not Nambor it was. He's going straight up the middle. And they've turned that one over. It was a knock on.
Brilliant defence, Bay of Plenty. They were up for that challenge there. There's some pats on the back. They're chipping away. They're talking.
Well, they're talking about defence, and they're hungry there as well. And a lot of them there, right in the middle of all that, was Zach Honick, the Bay of Plenty number seven, making a bit of noise. And that happens when you're on, you know, when you've had a hard week. Change here now for Pingi Talapatangi. He's been replaced by number 18, Ziggy Fishihoi.
He's chucked his way nicely around the park today, has Pingi Talapatangi.
He's a good solid replacement.
You've got to say, they do have some very good talent there. You still have the likes of Joe Royal as well. Sakalia. Apitanga. Excellent outing for the two prop forwards for Bay of Plenty. In the pretty difficult conditions, because the scrum has been the one area where counties really have dominated, and there'll be some pressure coming on right now for this scrum. Steelers will be looking at the clock. 15 minutes to go. Down by 18.
Yeah, there's too much weight. We're leaning on each other. Okay, get that space, please.
As we've now got front rows, all new. Johnny Fa'aoli, the man you saw in the red headgear for Counties Manukau, 19 years of age.
Crutch!
Directly out in front of their own goalpost, Bay of Plenty.
Set!
Kita presents, scrum goes down, penalty against Bay of Plenty at scrum time.
Well, they'll have
another. That one's on Fisihoi, is it?
Yeah, Fisihoi losing his feet. And Counties, well, why wouldn't they? Setting up camp now down on the 5 metre line, putting the pressure on, applying pressure. They do need to score. The clock is starting to work against them.
Let's see as the back line sets themselves up. And this is a familiar formation that we see. Two players directly behind the scrum, then two players split out left and right. That's Page and the Terry.
An important square scrum on defence. Bay will need to keep the square, not to promote any side and take the loose forwards out of it. As straight as possible.
My go-to man, Sam Barker, here on the left wing. He played, started off at centre. He's been very impressive in terms of breaking the line. There he is, left winger. But the key, scrum time. They might want to keep it close, Ben, but if they can give it to this guy one-on-one, it's looking dangerous this evening.
This has eaten up time, though. That knock-on was about 3 minutes ago, we've been informed. So that's 3 minutes that Counties Manukau don't have anymore.
It's a very, very good front row tactic, Nigel.
I'll take your word for that, Mr. Carson.
Crutch.
You're in the lead. Take some time.
Boy.
They don't call it the dark art for nothing, do they?
Set.
Judd to feed. Oh, that's a good scrum. That's a tight head. That's a legitimate tight head by Bay of Plenty. Onto the left foot and they clear. You saw the strike as well. That's old school stuff. Brilliant work.
Oh, brilliant pressure. Well, the man who was penalised, Ziggy Fisihoi, he stepped up to the party there. Came right up to the mark. Look at the weight come on. And then Nathan Harris, you see his boot come out and strike the ball. That's a great tight head. Chase Tietia in the back there, very happy with his forward pack.
I think Zeb Sigitunga is going to lay claim to that one. He's come on.
Ball comes out into the midfield where Vaipulu has been a willing carrier all afternoon. They keep coming out. Here's Vaenga. Page in there trying to clear out. Now Judd comes back to this right-hand side. Deferi, big dummy. Can he get away? No. Presents well, Judd. There is Nambor. Judd going again. Can he flick that ball back? No, but he presents well. Nambor pops the ball up to Vaka. Gets it out wide. Fa'aoli slips over to the line, but all over the top trying to get it, but he can't. There's Vaipulu. Mama steps back, gets the fend going. Still going, twisting and turning. Retallick over the top. Judd. Nambor to the line. They've got him up. That's not coming out of there. That'll be a turnover in favour of Bay of Plenty. Super work keeping him up and forcing the turnover.
Well, two good defenders. One of them, that man there. But Johan Bardul came in late as well and added his weight. That's a very good turnover. We'll see it here. Oh, one to Holland's head. Axton's Bardool. There he is, the big number four, wrapping his big arms around there. There was no way that ball was coming out. Called Maul to the deck. Good turnover.
This passage of play, Ben, will probably please Coach Clayton McMillan the most, wouldn't it? A lot of this, they've scored some wonderful tries, as we saw in the first half, but this is what a coach really wants to see, is this work, the team working hard, talking, you know, the talking's up. They're all very, very positive, but they haven't got the ball, so that's a real attitudinal thing.
Advantage in the breakdown turnovers for Bay of Plenty. 9-4 in that particular statistical element of the game. Scrum forms. Ball held at the back and away it comes. Kitta looking to Tarangi Fraser, out to Toma, who has taken station up on the right wing. Kitto, Bardool spins out a one, rolls and presents well. Kitto, they continue to work wide through Holland's head. Evermee, wide ball, chip and chase through. Does it sit up? Still going. Kraft Chimas, that's it. Nice try. Wonderful work by Famotu Kraft Chimas. And that, you suspect, we'll put it probably beyond doubt. Oh, we'll get in the hands, the ball into the hands of Dan Hollinshead, and that lovely wide ball from Evermeet and Kraft Chemis. Well, it was all in front of him here. Here it is. The second man play, and then a lovely ball now from Evermeet wide to Kraft Chemis. And a lovely little bit of school, Matthew Cooper. It's impressive.
Oh, it's lovely. It's opportunistic. But again, the two ball players there are Dan's Hollinshead and Kraft, and also the man that came on, Evermeet, the lovely wide ball. But gee, he had to do a lot, didn't he? And Kraft Chemis coming through. Faimutu Kraft Chemis over the try. He's happy. All that ball counties have had, Ben Castle, and look what's happened. The big turnaround at the other end of the field.
Well, you talked about attitude on defence and not having the ball and how a team steps up. Well, they certainly showed plenty of character, and then they get the ball back and produce one of the tries of the match.
Holland's head. Just add to the insurance factor. Nice strike. Lovely conversion. And that just pads the lead out nicely for Bay of Plenty. Who will remain third in the championship, but just keep themselves within touching distance of Hawke's Bay and Wellington.
Well, it's a good story, though, too, Nigel, isn't it? They didn't have much success, didn't they, at all? I don't think they had any success last year. So Bay of Plenty, three good wins.
Great as well to see Faimotu Kraft Chemis. Some heartland rugby from East Coast and Poverty Bay. Comes out of that great rugby academy of Gisborne Boys High School, where he was an absolute superstar. Here is the ball for Bay of Plenty. And they're just going to try and play it down the other end of the field. They have played a very smart game of rugby. And Clayton McMillan will be rightfully chuffed, one suspects. He gets his team into the changing room at the end of the night. Here comes Judd. Teteri. Dropped by Paoli.
And just big 19's there too, Nigel, on the left there. Keeper Miotti's on there now for the captain, Retallick. And Joe Royal, number one. So he's replaced number one, Solomona Sakalia, for Bay of Plenty. Good man, Joe Royal.
Great to see Joe there. And you can see, talk about all these wonderful servants of Bay of Plenty Rugby. You mentioned Clayton McMillan, 113 games for the Steamers in his playing career. I was lucky enough to speak to him prior to the start of the season, and you could just hear the passion in his voice for the team and for the region. It's a slow process, but he's done very well with regards to getting these guys onto his way of thinking very quickly, and the rewards are being seen.
Set!
Kitto. Nice strike. Slow to come back. There it is now. Kitto away. Holland's head. They continue to wrap around and go wide. Here's Tarangi Fraser trying to cut back and get the fend going. Pops the ball up. It's been left behind by Tiatia. Ball has been knocked on, and so we'll take another scrum. Really just have slowed down. It was quite a frenetic pace at times, but it's just sort of gradually eased throughout the course of this game. As we look at Tarangi Fraser on the replay.
Thank you. Eight.
Come on.
Yep, do it now.
Diving, still showing plenty of energy as Zach Honick, as right, Sean Edu has to go back on.
And the other co-captain.
Give that space.
Carl Axton.
The side. Okay,
good effort from him. Yeah, the number eight jumper today. Joe Tupai.
Crouch!
Number 20 at the base of the scrum.
Bind!
We've seen players go on, players come off, players go back on again.
No, you're pretty engaged.
Matthew Cooper trying to keep up with everything. Here is Mama Vaipulu. Carries strong into contact, looks to lay that ball and present, and does so. Judd. Detiri sees a gap, tries to get underneath. Taken down though by Bale Clinton. Judd. Coming back on that angle. Nimble. Judd. Aono trying to get that ball to the outside to Vaipulu. That was a great tackle by Hollins here. Aono. And Aolangi with a good strong carry. Judd. Comes wide to Page. Vainga. Detiri. Going straight, that's a better run by Henwood. Gets it away to Fa'aoli. Has to go back inside. Johnny gets away from one, pops it up to Judd, and he's going to get a double for the day. That's a beautiful try, finished off by Richard Judd. And that's the sort of rugby that we like and have come to know from County's Manukau, Ben Castle.
Oh, Henwood, the one with the break. He said, give me the ball. He straightened up the attack and broke through. That's a very, very good attack. As it goes wide here through Vaianga, then the short ball, just running hard onto Joe Royal, and then just put his foot down. And Johnny Fa'aoli, he did very well around defenders, and then presence of mind and great backing up from the halfback, Richard Judd, over a brace for him today.
Yeah, they just show you, don't they, how dangerous they can be. There's the conversion for County's Manukau. It was over.
So that brings it back now to within 18 points. And I guess what Counties is now thinking, one more try.
Yeah, bonus point, one more try.
That gets them the bonus point. Another try could earn them another bonus point. Remember, we have already seen a team score a bunch of tries in a very short period of time here at Echo Light Stadium in Pukekohe. Manawatu got it. They're galloping home with the wind in their sails. Can the home side recapture that?
Bay of Plenty making their way slowly back to the halfway line.
Is that an old front rower's trick as well?
Well, it's probably just retired. More than anything.
Restart, Bay of Plenty going deep, and it's taken nicely. They'll try to keep this in hand. They go away to Mama Vaipulu, who steps and then accelerates, and he gets away. Does Mama still going? Needs support. Gets it through Lawrenson. Flinging that ball around. Oh, turnover. No. Wide it comes. And Aolangi. Trying to step and bounce his way through again as Henwood, the man who created that try for Judd just moments ago. Vaianga. Aono. Carries to halfway. Judd. Onga Aolangi. Presents that ball. Judd, short ball. Henwood again. This time they try and stop him, but all is there. We've got a real way on here, County's Manukau. Here it is to Page. Sees a gap. Can he get that ball up? No, he can't. There's Vaipulu. They're doing this all with 14 because Lawrenson's down in back play at the moment. Judd. Number with a good strong carry. Juggles it. Still going, Sakelli. Gets the ball away to Vaka. He flicks it up to Fa'aoli. Aono. Big carry by Big Sam. Judd. Here is Number again to within five. Judd. Number's right. Here it comes. Taufua, low, lost his footing a smidge. Pick and go once again, Bagshaw. Anga Aolangi goes in with a big clean out.
Hold here, hold here.
Pick and go by Sione. Bonus point try beckoning for the Steelers. And boy, low, driving to the line. He's got there. 37-24. Kick would make it 37-26. The chance to maybe sneak another bonus point. They're going to have to get a wriggle on, though. I don't know if they're going to have enough time. Nice work, though. Bonus point try for the Steelers.
Yeah, well done, Counties. They've been down on the scoreboard all day. It's been a hard evening at it, but they've got some really good build-up there from their forwards. getting their hands on the ball. Good, strong carries. Nando.
I won't put as much pressure on
them. Haono. Anga. Alangi.
We'll have a restart, though.
There is time for the restart. So two bonus points potential. So the conversion is over. The advantage for Bay of Plenty. This is lovely stuff, Matthew Cooper.
Oh, it is. I mean, they're just showing again, ball in hand. The only problem is that they've just lost the ball too many times. Ball come out. Good hit into the old wall there. Gave him a nice bit of shoulder.
That was a nice, a number 10 lying over a ruck.
They love that, don't they? And there he is, and the ball over. So they're chasing maybe another bonus here.
So the lead is 11. So a try would get them another bonus point. Taufua. This could be an entertaining wee finish to this game. Ball, though, has been turned over. Counties go driving in. It's been knocked on.
Guys, we got time for a score?
Waiting for the call.
Yeah, there is time.
There is time.
Yep.
Come on. Let's go.
Sorry.
The opportunity. That's the 10-metre mark in County's Manukau series, territory.
Just wait till I say blind. I'll come have a look. Okay? But let's have ear to ear.
Richard Kelly still working hard as an official to make sure the scrum works. Siren goes in the background.
Bind!
Judd.
Set!
Impression. Judd has made since he's come on, bagging a double. Good scrum. Counties Manukau to the back. Judd. Diteri. For Aoli. White, it goes to Page, who juggles it and then tries to dance his way out of trouble. He gets good support, though. Presents well. Vaipulu looks at his options. Away it goes. Lawrenson, who's managed to get himself up off the deck. Good defence, Bay of Plenty. Judd trying to step his way back through. He hasn't hindered, been good. He's also made an impact. The bench of Counties Manukau has had a real impact on this game. It's Paoli again. Short ball. Hanwood. Wow. Big defence. That was Tupou with the tackle. Here they come. Holland's head. He's going to kick it through. It's going to go too far. Not going to matter. That's the game. And that is a vital win for Bay of Plenty in the championship, knocking off.